Cause I know I didn't tell nobody. I hadn't told nobody. I got you. You're the only person I told, and I sent, and
Okay.
yeah, and then I told Adele. So y'all two the only people that know. He just told their parents yesterday. I mean, well, he just told them yesterday. But wait till I tell him about you. What color is it? I'm just because I'm over here. Look, sometimes it takes me a minute, but when I get into that mode, I'll be ready to help you spend your money. I'm like, girl, get the big one. Go all out. Wait till February and buy
Yeah,
all
get
out.
one of each. How about that?
Huh?
You're like, get one of each.
Get one of each. Girl, look, ain't no sense to me lying when you said, but they could give me the car sooner. Wait, wait, let me finish. Let me finish. Let me finish. Let me finish. When you said I might get the car because they can get that to me faster, I was thinking in addition to. I'm like, oh, wait, she's going to get a car, and then February she's going to get the big one. Oh, man. I was going to just, oh, man. I might tell that before I tell them the actual.
Oh, yeah.
I might tell them that first.
Hold up.
She
get Why
both.
You getting excited? Let's not forget, I'm still the only one in this house working.
Yeah, let us all always remember that. Let us always remember that.
Look,
yeah. And I get that, like, even from the other end, and that's the reason why, you know, even though it would like for me to have some designated projects for him to do around here, I gotta clean up my shit first. You know what I mean? And you, when you and you, he deserved. He worked so much and so hard and so many freaking hours to make sure that I have my needs and a few of my wants as well. Like he, even when he come in, And I'm kind of fussing at me for both of y'all right now. Like, what he look like having to walk around clothes that need to be simple washed or some shit like that. Because every time you say, keep in mind, I'm the only one in this house working, I know it don't feel like it, but he got to know, I understand, you know, that's real. And I think, and that at least is the benefit for us in this household, is I do recognize, you know, that he is doing a thing and that breadwinner thing. And like you said, it ain't even just the money even. It's just like a participating in building your life so you can live in your elder lives, you know, in health and wellness and neatness. You know, you don't want to be no hoarders either. So, God forbid you got the room to pile shit up.
Right.
So, yeah, yeah, when you say that, I'd be with you on caping for team. And that's why I was so glad when you had called him that day. I knew he had talked to somebody he loved. And he could relate to. He was feeling. And girl, when I tell you he came home, I was like, oh, well, y'all had work today. It wasn't slow. What's good? They didn't give you no drama. What's good? And eventually, he said, he was like, you heard from Carol? And I can't remember what I said. I don't know if you had. Maybe you didn't. I don't know. Text me that day. But he was like, yeah, I got to talk to my sister today. I was like, oh, I'm so glad, girl. He was in a good mood the whole night, bitch. The whole night he was in a good mood.
I know when I talked to him recently and I told him, like, you know, I had a new job and I was telling him about.
Yeah, he can relate to that,
know,
all that
beer. You did anything to warrant.
Yeah.
No real good reason.
In fact, you could be the one that they could have. They knew you was the one they could always call on to clean up a mess that they made. But they still got some.
Because between me and you,
I'm sitting here like, she better not let them white people at the job know she got a Tesla. Because they be feeling some type of way. They feel like we can't possibly should be able to afford. You know what I mean?
Right, we paying you too much.
Yes! They be feeling like that. Even when they like you.
But here's the deal.
They don't.
It got nothing to do with you.
Right, but with black people, they don't. They think that they really feel entitled over our lives. That's why we can't.
Yeah, like they got some kind of power over. Or no.
It's like. Let me give you a small example. It's like, this is a realistic example though. But black people going into a Starbucks where it's a bunch of white people in there, and a couple of teenagers, drinking coffee, expensive coffee. A couple of black people come in for a business meeting. Most of the white people in that Starbucks gonna be like, who is that? Like, what do y'all do? And if you don't sing in a choir and you're not a rapper or athlete, how could you possibly, what are you even doing in here drinking this type of coffee? How did you even know, you know? I think you're in the wrong place. You know. You go to the counter, I need to use the bathroom because you got to get a key. You be like, oh, only customers use the bathroom. Bitch, I'm sitting at that table with them other three Negroes. Like, you've assumed I'm not a customer. I mean, it's just example, but I'm just saying. And I know it's true because I've worked for white people that liked me. And I know that they felt like they just can't help it. I work for a white dude that knows white people do that. And he can't explain why, but he's one of those people that know it is what it is. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I remember being young and working for actually some black people, and because we get conditioned to do it, some of the other managers, I got promoted to management, and some of the other managers was getting cars because they always try to do what the CEO did. The CEO would get at least a new car every 2 years and do it from Texas because they taxes are cheaper and all that stuff. So he always had, you know, whatever. So that's what they tried to do, and so they tried to get me to get. This was when cell phones was even still first getting popular, right? So they wanted me to get a cell phone and a new car and stuff. And you know what I did? I looked at my 22-year-old self looked at them and said, I said, the difference between me and you in our positions, because now I'm in there, you know, I'm a manager as well. I said, the difference between me and you is I recognize what I can't afford. Like, being a manager is not just to flex. I'm a manager and go and spend everything you just made. I was like, you trying to keep up with the CEO? He ain't a manager. He the CEO. He can go and get, he can throw the car in a little trash can big enough and get a new one.
Right.
And y'all,
right.
And it, right. And y'all, and so now you got a Volvo and you got a Benz and they old. They were 90s because they had to be old because you can't afford the current year that he can. Trying to keep up with him, and now you got to pay more in parts just to go have them lemons fixed every other week.
Ain't no joke. Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, I'm gonna watch y'all go through that, cause I'm not gonna do it. I can't. Guess what? I'm not ashamed to say I can't afford it. What the hell?
Mm-hmm.
I can't afford it. And he expects us. He expects us not to shop off the rack, cause the CEO, not the other managers. Because his theory is, and that's okay, cause that comes that came with the job, and he. He was clear. He's like, I pay y'all enough to be able to dress a certain way. Because his theory was, if people are aspiring to be like you, it's real materialistic. But he's like, if they can go in and get something off the rack just like you can, that's no aspiration. You know, they already on your level. So that was his financially aristocracy idea. But, you know, I get it fine. And I can't say, he paid us enough to be able to shop. But I wasn't being paid enough to go out and just get a new car every couple of years. I wasn't even getting paid enough to get a new car for that year to drive for several years. So I'm not that chick. But y'all go on. And I'm telling you, every other week, they had them Volvos and Mercedes in the shops. And guess what? I was going to have lunch with the CEO in his car, because that's all the car I needed. He used to love to have me, and I couldn't stand him, but he liked having me come to eat lunch with him because he got sick of all them people trying to kiss his butt all the time.
Mm-hmm.
He want to be with somebody that's going to tell him the truth for a change. Because I remember the first time he told me, he was like, "Why? How come you don't ever do, you know, he's asking why I don't do like other people do, like they be bringing him coffee and shit. Fuck you mean, bringing you coffee.
He didn't bring me coffee.
Girl, I love, like, chai-bye. I was like, and the reason why he always asked me is to tell the truth. He realized it. He realized these people ain't sincere. I was like, what you need to do is figure out who is really on your team. Because that's where your money come from. You going to be about your business, be about it. I get you got to keep some yes men around, but realize they roll, you know? They there to make you feel like they on your team the whole time. That's their whole job. That's a yes man's job, to make you feel like they always on your team. But he was defensive of me too. I think it was some dude came in and I think he said something about, you know, he thought I was cute or something. And he said something on his way. He was new. I was walking out the office or something, and the guy said something. Ooh, boy, my boss pumped his brakes so fast. I felt so proud of that. Because I warranted respect. You know what I mean? I warranted the respect that other chicks did not command.
Mm-hmm.
They so busy trying to kiss up and sleep with everybody. And I'm like, no, what you not going to do? Nope, not me. And if we work together, you're not my type. Because somebody that would sleep with a chick that would do something like that is not my type. So you can press the F on with that. But they respected me. Then not one person would ever be able to say I slept my way anywhere. Oh, I'll be making fun of him. Because let him tell it. He bought me a purse. And he'll swear I tried to break up with him after he tried me. He had bought me a real expensive purse or whatever. And then I just remembered we was watching some show or something, and some dude bought the chick a car or something like that. I was like, don't do it, girl. Don't take it, girl. Don't take the car. Because I had forgot. He had also bought me a car. He bought me a Stanza when we was dating. That was a semi-traumatic for me, because ain't nobody ever bought me a damn car. You know, who does that? And we wasn't even dating that long. Like, who does? It wasn't a new car, but... Girl, I was riding I had been riding a Metro train and riding my bike from the train to the house. You know what I mean? And I didn't have no problem. I was riding my bike, girl, to the stepper sets.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Yeah, and I had no embarrassment about it. I was, lock my bike up and go and dance the whole night away and go and get on my bike and ride. We know when I found some place close enough. So, but anyway, I was coming from work or something or whatever, and he had done got me a little stanza.
Oh, nice.
I know. Who does that? I mean, who does that? I was like, no.
I guess he did.
Yeah, I guess so. But some people get Teslas and whatnot, and they get to choose between big body babies. Big body babies in sports. Well, I'm gonna look it up after. I wanna see. I'm so excited. Was it 2021? What are we talking about? Do you know why this is also wonderful? Because I can live vicariously through you, because I'm not that person. But for someone I love who is, it's like I'm living through you. It's so awesome. But to be fair, if all this passes by, if you come down here one time when Adele down here too, because Adele and them building, they building got Tesla spots. That's true, but they don't have, but there are certain, certain charging stations that are specifically Teslas rather than any kind of charge. You know what I mean? Like the spaces at her building, they literally say Tesla, like only Tesla.
Right.
Oh man, just to imagine that I walk by them spaces all the time and don't think twice, because that is not my life. But and now every time I walk by them, I'm gonna be like, oh, my sister could park there. I don't care where I'm at. I don't care where I'm at. I bet not ever see the word Tesla nowhere. I'll be, oh yeah, that my sister could do that.
He's trying to discourage me. She said,
it's already set up.
She's trying to make it seem like, just because I have to order a special charging station for my garage, then I probably wouldn't be interested. And I'm like, no, I'm getting it.
You're like, that goes with it. That's how it works.
This is happening.
Like, is it right? This is happening.
To prevent this from happening.
That's hilarious. This is happening, honey. Go ahead. Just relax. Let it do what it do. Oh, man. Oh, boy. You shouldn't have never told me this. I'm almost spend the whole rest of 2020.
I don't have to check my engine. There is no engine.
Right. Oh, I can't wait till this be over. You know I want to ride in it too. That's what Adele told me. Adele, when she got the picture, she saw the picture of my car. She's like, oh, I want to ride in it with you. I was so like, I was laughing so hard. I was like, that's so funny. I was like, cause all my adult life, it's been my sisters, you and Adele. Y'all be having the cars, I be wanting to ride in. I was like, well, I just be riding in. I be scared to even drive. And I was laughing about how that time, I was telling about how that time, I told you when I went to Texas and didn't even know how it already
got. Oh, yeah.
I didn't know what the fuck. I was like, oh, my God. And I know he's happy that I'm happy with my car, because I had told him, I was like, I'm so glad. I was like, I be getting so bougie when we drive by a smaller one, because, we had narrowed everything down, because he looked like he wanted to get me a Benz for a little while, and I really wasn't having it. And then the more he looked at them, the less I wanted one, because he said, like, they didn't even start their electronic upgrades till like 2009, which was late for a luxury car. You know what I mean? Like, all the other luxury cars had certain amenities, and Benz was late, apparently. Like, they look amazing on the outside, but then when it comes to the features, he's like, they just don't live up to what should be considered a luxury. And the more I looked at stuff, I was like, yeah, like, I'm feeling some type of way at this point. Like, Benz, like, y'all, what y'all doing? So we kept leaning away from Benz, and he was looking at Lexus. And I was like, but everybody, I was like, my people, they all had Lexus and whatever. And then he told me, so then he was talking, he had mentioned Infiniti before anyway. And plus, I wanted something that and it wasn't going to be a GTR. We ain't doing that. So I was like, okay, well, let's look at the Infiniti. So we started looking at the Infinitis, and we were looking for, of course, the small ones first. But as the more we looked, I was like, well, I don't know. Sometimes they kind of just look like a regular, like a Honda or something. I don't know. Mm-hmm. I was like, it's something about them, right? So when we went to drive one, I was kind of shading it, because I be talking trash about it. He got an Altima, and I be talking, because it looks nice, but when you sit in it, it feel like a cardboard box to me. I'm like, it don't drive smooth, it drive like a box, but it do got some get up, girl. I don't know, I ain't never been in no car, you touch the gas and it take off. I was like, this should be a race car. But anyway, so we was driving the smaller ones, and I was like, this remind me of the Altima. I was like, this feel kind of boxy, like wooden boxy.
Right.
And I was like, I don't know. I was like, maybe I'm starting to understand why old people who always got them Bonnevilles and stuff, the long, big car. Like, why old people get them big old cars for? And I was
like
girl, I was like, the older I get, though, I think I get it. I think I get it. So we drove the we drove a few of the smaller Xfinities, and I was like, yeah, I was like, they nice, it's nice. I was like, but it just it remind me, it give me remnants of that Altima for some reason. And we start looking at the bigger ones. He had looked at a bigger one, found a big one or whatever. Mm-hmm. And plus it had a bunch of little, you know, upgrades and remote starter. It had a bunch of extra stuff. So we went to look at it and we drove it. And I was like, oh, okay, see. And I thought about your car and I thought about Adele's car. Mm-hmm. And I was like, this is what a luxury car feels like. The eyes like, it, I don't even know because I ever had one, but my people got them. Mm-hmm. And I know what they're supposed to feel like. So I was like, okay. And it felt so luxury that it meant I felt out of place like I did at the rental car place. And so I was like, okay, this is what it feels like. Because I feel like I'm being chaperoned even though I'm driving. That's what it. That's what I think about. So, yeah, we went ahead and went with the big one. And I've told him several times since then. I was like, I'm so glad we got the big one. I was like, now when I look at them little ones, I get all fancy. And I'm like, ugh.
And
look
then
at
also,
them.
Too, when you get a car.
I told him, and I know he felt good about that because, like I said, he been trying to get me a new car for a few years. Well, new to me, it ain't no, you know, it's still 10 years old. But that now it's only 10 years old and not 20. So, but it still has the features that I wasn't accustomed to. But, so, you know, I was like, I came out of the store today or out of post office or something. And I was looking for my car. No, it couldn't have been a post office because that ain't that big, the store. And I was like, I was looking for a car. And I was like, for the first time in my life, because he been trying to get me a new car and I ain't get it. I'm happy. I don't need no new car. But for the first time in my life, I looked out and I saw. I was like, "Is that my car?" I was like, "That's not my car." I was like, "I felt like that was a hoopty." I was like, "That's not my car." I was like, "So for the first time, he was like, oh, he was like, I'm so glad. I'm so glad.' So you know, that was his green light. He was like, oh, this must be time I can get the car now." I told him, I was like, now when I come out, I was like, sometimes I'll just start the car just because it's there. Just because it got a remote start. And I'm like, you know, well, no need to start the car. But I'm going to start. Be walking toward it. It's going to start. Yeah, I'm still, like I said, I'm still getting used to the features. But, hey, you know, it's really amazing, impressive. I can't wait to ride in your car. Woo! What you talking about? And COVID need to hurry up and wrap it up at this point. Because if it don't,
I know.
I'm going to be like, babe, you ready to go risk COVID to go ride in your car? We're gonna risk it all, right? Oh yeah, no, I meant ride around in the car when I said that.
You're like, no, I really
Cause yesterday after we left his parents, we had intended to go because we been wanting to go for a ride ever since I got the car, and we just like, well, we just go for a drive, you know. We thought road trip, but then when you go on a road trip, you end up somewhere, so we just gonna go for a long drive and back. And we never did go, so we was going, after last night, we was going to go and look at, you know, drive around, because they live in a bougie area neighborhood, so we was going to drive around their area and look at Christmas lights, but like I said, we didn't leave there until after 10, so I was like, nah, that's not going to work out. Well, I can't wait. I can't wait till we get our car.
Oh, Lord.
I can't wait. Oh, I'm getting cars all over the place in 2020.
Mm-hmm. All over
All up in these streets, literally and figuratively.